there's a lot of conversation going on. That's good. I would encourage you, maybe if you haven't, leave that question up there, sermon at the end. Because if you haven't written this down or remember it, that's a question to keep having a conversation about during the week. How can we do good for others outside the church and at home this week? And because our mission, when Jesus calls us and says, I am, you're who I say you are, right? I am who you say I am. And he invites us to believe, and we do, and we say yes. Then we also take on a mission. And the mission that we take on isn't our mission. It's his. It's Jesus' mission. And when we say, yes, I want to be part of that, his mission is still, after 2,000 plus years, go out, not stay put. Right? It's go out, not stay put. Anthony, you want to put that following Jesus slide up? Because that's what I want you to do. You're focusing on what does it mean to follow Jesus. It means to follow his mission, right? Not mine. And his mission was, in a word,
go.
Oh, come on. It's like, thank you. It's like, really? Does he mean go? No, I like you here. Yes, he meant to go. We went through 6 chapters of Mark as he's unfolding it to his friends, as he's calling them to join the mission. They're a little confused about that, and they're uncertain. And he keeps saying, Jesus, just stay put here. They're all flocking to you. And every time that happens, Jesus says, yeah, but let's go. Let's go somewhere else. Because the mission is to bring hope and healing in Jesus' name, not just to the people who will walk into the church on their own, but the people who will never walk into the church. See, what Jesus is saying is, don't just invite community to church, and we should. He's saying, go and be church in the community. And that's what you were talking about a moment ago. You're saying, where are those places that I live? The team that I'm on, the friends that I have in school, the people that I work with, the people that I play with in some activity, the people at the gym that I started to have a relationship with. Where can I do good
there?
Not preach a sermon, but where can I do good? And so bring Jesus hope and healing and love where they need it. And that might even be helping them cast out a few demons. It might be stuff like, you know, there are people that struggle with addictions. And maybe you show them there's another way. There are people that struggle with loneliness. And maybe you show them there's someone out there who will listen to them. Maybe there's somebody who's really struggling at school, and you're pretty smart. And instead of just doing your own thing, you help them out. You help them get a better grade. Maybe you help them on your sports team to improve their skills. And you know what you're doing? You're doing good where you are. And isn't that Jesus' mission? Didn't Jesus say, go? And as you go, do good, and as then God gives you the opportunity, share good news. Share good news of hope and healing in Jesus' name. And we'll talk a little bit more about that next week as we talk about what it means to invite a friend. But today I want you to end by focusing on this. What if we actually did what we were talking about? And what if everybody here today, instead of, we do these things as a church, and this is good. We do things like pat things at the whole church for Guatemala or for Operation Christmas Child. We say, hey, here's a day to serve, and we do. But a lot of times when we say, here's a day to serve, we get 5 or 6, 10 people because everybody's schedules is complicated, right? Or that might not even be my heart mission. I don't feel like pulling weeds, and I don't feel like cleaning up the neighborhood. I don't feel like helping the homeless. But what if we did this? What if you just said, as the church, everybody here today, in the next 2 weeks, I did good. How many people would be out there bringing church to the world? Doing good in Jesus' name. Helping at the point that you see someone needs help. Did you do that? And what would happen if we all did that together? And we just like celebrating, like hashtag I served, or said, hey, here's what happened when I was out and I did this thing. What difference could it make? I'll tell you one thing it would do. We'd be following Jesus. We'd be doing what he said. Go out and do good. I want to challenge you in the next 2 weeks. Will you do that? Outside of home, keep doing it at home. And outside of church, keep doing it at church. But in the next 2 weeks, will you say, yeah, Jesus, I'm going to follow you. I'm going to go. Have eyes to see, and I'm going to do good right where I am and bring the church to the community. That's following Jesus. Will you do it? I'm going to. Thanks for being here today. Next week, we are going to talk about inviting a friend and what that part is in the mission of Jesus. I'm going to encourage you to come back. I'm going to encourage you to tell a friend. I'm going to encourage you to tell them about family worship and what we do here. Now's the time where we take our financial gifts and offerings. I want to thank probably the 80% of you that have already given online. You made that automatic. Thank you. If God wants you to give